BBC Audio presents Arabian Afternoons, a collection of three full-cast dramas inspired by tales from the Arabian Nights. The Casper Logue Affair by Sebastien Baczkiewicz.
And when you listen to the servants, the people of the palace, what do they say about their king, Shahrazad? There's no need to be shy, child. Speak.
They say that you are cruel, Radiant Majesty.
Cruel. Fascinating. Fig.
Your Majesty dishonors himself.
Consider it a gift in exchange for your candor. Take one, please.
Thank you.
They are right, of course, about my cruelty. Spot on, in fact.
Are they?
Are they not?
I would say that both you and they are mistaken.
Even though you will be dead by daybreak?
Yes.
So, tell me how it is that a king who has dispatched 1,000 brides cannot be considered cruel. Speak, child. Amaze me with your acumen.
I would say that the great king Shahryar is not cruel, but indifferent. As a cat is indifferent to the bird he has just snatched and killed, toying aimlessly with its carcass in the still of the afternoon, waiting idly for some new distraction.
And what distraction could you possibly offer me?
A story.
And you imagine that a story will save you from this great indifference of mine?
I believe a story may save us all.
Then please, amaze me.
As your Majesty desires. In the great and ancient city of Baghdad, there was once a lowly servant of the state.
Goldacre!
And it was this same poor Bob Goldacre's responsibility to ensure the well-being of a most favored merchant from the strange and wonderful land of America. A merchant by the name of...
Logue! Casper Logue. Pleasure to meet you, Bob. Can't tell you how glad I am to be on board with you today, fella.
Casper Logue, a gentleman whose diminished stature was matched only by the exaggerated size of his purse.
Wait, Shahrazad, wait. What is this land of which you speak?
America. A place of unimaginable wealth and plenty, Majesty.
Greater than mine?
The story that I am telling you, O wise and happy king, took place a long, long time ago. An age of marvels, both terrible and wondrous. When the potholed roads heaved with vehicles packed with weapons of terrifying and deadly effectiveness. When words and pictures could be transmitted on the wind by jinns of unimaginable power.
Good evening, I'm Charlene Lane, and fears are growing in Baghdad as to the whereabouts of businessman Casper Logue. Early reports are inconclusive, but it would appear that Mr. Logue, executive director of the Levinson Hotel Syndicate, was abducted as he toured the Mansour district of the city. Official sources are keen to stress that it is too early to speculate on exactly what has taken place, but they are not ruling out the possibility of kidnapping, as potentially yet another name is added to the sad and ever-growing list of abductees in that troubled area.
And this, as you may imagine, O wise and happy king, was not altogether good news for Bob Goldacre.
You lost him, Bob? How the hell did you lose him?
I don't know, sir. One second Mr. Logue was with us on the street, and the next he'd completely disappear.
And you didn't try to stop him, Bob?
I know how it sounds, Mr. Hammond, sir, but I swear he just vanished.
Vanished?
Vanished.
Casper Logue. A guest. A guest, Bob, of the United States government, and a friend. A personal friend of mine. Just vanished on a Baghdad side street? Is that what you're telling me?
Obviously, I take full responsibility for everything, sir.
You got that right, Bob. Now, from the top, again, exactly what happened?
Yes, sir. Of course, sir. Nothing like this has ever happened to me before, sir, and I can't apologize enough.
Just get on with it.
Well, as I described in my report, I had turned to speak to one of the other delegates on the street, when Mr. Logue interjected.
These other delegates sure look nervous, don't they, Bob?
As long as we stay inside of the security personnel in the Humvee, we should be fine, Mr. Logue. Now, if you just bear with me a moment, I have to speak to Mr.
You know,
Guthrie.
To tell you the honest truth, I wasn't quite expecting there to be so many delegates. I thought old Rick Hammond had arranged this little trip just for me.
Well, you'd have to speak to Mr. Hammond about that.
Oh, I intend to, Bob. I intend to. Now, tell me, that street over there is Alamira Street, isn't it?
Yes, sir, it is, but it's not really on our itinerary.
It isn't. I thought Hammond arranged it specifically.
Well, as you know, Baghdad's still an extremely volatile city.
And either the American and Iraqi governments wants guys like me to assess its potentialities, or it doesn't.
Yeah, I'm sorry, Mr. Logue. I don't know what Mr. Hammond may have said to you, but this really isn't the safest district to investigate.
Well, hell, Bob, that's the whole reason I'm out here.
Is there a problem over there, Mr. Goldacre?
Be with you in just one moment, Mr. Guthrie. Maybe you ought to speak directly to Mr. Hammond when we get back to the embassy in the Green Zone. He'd be much better placed to advise you as to what's happened.
You saying you can't make decisions for yourself, Bob?
No, I'm saying that that would be an unscheduled trip in an unstable district, Mr. Logan. While you're within my zone of responsibility, I need you and all the other delegates to observe the established protocols.
Don't you try and tongue-twist me with that Pentagon patois, Bob. You want to get someplace in this world? Then you better start thinking out of the box.
Everyone back in the Humvee, right now! Mr. Logue! Mr. Logue!
I do recognize that this is my responsibility, Mr. Hammond. I do.
Is that right?
Yes, sir. But I had the other delegates to deal with, and Mr. Logue seemed determined to go off on his own, no matter what.
And it was your job to make sure he didn't. Hammond. No, I already told you, Maxine. No calls unless it's urgent. Now tell whoever it is that this office has no comment to make at this time. What? Oh, I see. Okay, put him through. Yes, of course, I'll hold. Boy, oh boy. That Casper Logue.
I understand that we've closed down the entire Mansour district, sir.
Not a problem?
No, sir. It's just...
Just what?
We wouldn't want to make a bad situation worse, would we?
Finding Mr. Logue is our first responsibility, over and above all else, including public relations. Just hold on there a second, Bob. Yes, this is Rick Hammond. Hello there, Sergeant. Would you mind saying that again, please? All right. I'm going to come right down and see the suspect right now. And I'm sure I don't need to remind you of the sensitivity of this situation.
Is everything all right, sir?
My God, Maxine, how many times do I have to... Oh, when does he want to speak with me? Okay, tell the ambassador I'll be right here. That was the ambassador. He's demanding some kind of explanation right now. Which means I'm going to go against my better judgment and trust you with this, Bob.
Of course, sir. Anything. Thank you.
I need you to go down to Holding Cell 7Q and interview a gentleman by the name of Waylon Kinderman, head chef of the Happy Pizza.
The Happy Pizza?
Located 300 yards from this building, smack in the beating heart of the Green Zone.
I'm not sure I understand, sir.
Mr. Kinderman was arrested tonight for trying to dispose of the body of Casper Logue at 2100 hours.
Does that mean Mr. Logue's...
dead. Yes, Bob, Mr. Logue's dead. Dead is your damn career if you mess this interview up. You got yourself one of these, Goldacre?
I don't have a gun, sir. No, I didn't think it was
allowed.
Well,
it might not be a bad idea to get yourself one. And it goes without saying, I want this Kinderman fella dealt with discreetly. You answer to me, and nobody else. Clear?
Clear.
Now, get going, and don't screw it up.
And so, with a full and heavy heart, poor Bob Goldacre trudges wearily along the dust-encrusted corridors to fulfill his unfortunate duty. While... At that very same moment, in a poorly furnished room, in a quiet corner of the Mansour district,
and the devil is six, and the devil is six.
in a one-bedroom apartment occupied by Rahim the tailor and his beautiful wife Asira.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.